Hachi. This is Hachi. We are making a tufted
mattress cushion.
Yep.
And welcome to our midnight tufting session.
So as you can see, oops,
we've done the entire corners, the edges, well not this one yet, and we decided, because it does take two people for this project, at least, most also.
At most, yeah, you can't.
You can't really do it one and two, but you need to. So
we're at the part
where we're doing these final tufts. So get your upholstery needle, at least 6 inches, preferably 8.
We tried different needles. This is definitely the easiest.
And your upholstery thread.
Upholstery thread. Yes, it's gonna need to be tough. So we've calculated on both sides where the holes go for the tufts on top and on the bottom.
You have to double check them.
It's very well divided, so it doesn't look unplanned. So,
because you don't want accidental tufting.
No. Once you've done the tuft, you don't want to do it again.
Right. Like we're doing right now, because we messed up.
But it's worth it, you know, if you get this far. So you poke it through and hope it that it's going straight. You can use a bottle cap, for example. I think Pellegrino's probably the best.
I like Mountain Valley Spring, but you know.
Yes, that's true. That's true. See, this one's going too low. I'm just going to take it out.
So you need your friend here.
To encourage.
But also, so one person can push, one person can pull, one person can squeeze.
So this is going to be here and we'll come back and fix.
There you go.
Push, pull. Push, pull. Don't pull too much.
Because it pulls all the way through. But you're with us for a good example. You're with us for some of the struggles.
Yeah.
And you know, the first one we did, we really struggled. And the second, and the third, we kind of got the hang of it.
So you see, this is our upholstery uniform.
You see the gray bands with the white thread.
And
one, make sure
like
one's in dark gray,
yeah.
And one's in light gray.
Yes, exactly.
And represent.
You want to try to match the
one
very monochromatic scene right here.
And you would be one with the cushion as your tufting.
What?
One with the cushion.
Well, yes, you have to be
and
one. One.
You know.
Yes. So. Okay. I'll try this again. We're aiming for this hole. Can you see? This is great. You can do it, Hachi.
Trusty bottle cap.
So you see what she's doing here? She's feeling with her fingers to see where it's coming so she can kind of guide it more.
And I kind of pulled it all the way through again. So,
so
the,
that means that,
that means
the
knot, that
knot
was
small.
Not good. Not good.
Okay.
We'll probably edit this part out of the video.
Just the second knot part?
The fourth knot part. And we'll skip ahead to where the knot actually catches.
Yes. But these things do happen.
These things definitely happen. In fact, they happen more often than they don't. On the other hand, the ridge tufting, we seem to get a system down.
Yeah, and that's what
we did
our second video with our longer,
our larger cushion.
Yeah. But here we go again.
Here we go again.
Second time's the charm.
There you go.
Perfect.
Boom.
Don't pull too hard. What you want to do is that. Oh, maybe I should hold it on that side.
Yep. I'll hold it. I think that like that's what we're doing. You were holding it, so let me hold it so it doesn't go through.
That's
the knot is fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just don't pull it.
Okay. Don't lose the knot.
Okay.
There we go. Let me go back in.
Back in.
Yeah, Monet is really happy with that stitch, and we're going to try it yet again, and so you're aiming for an X stitch,
an X
it
shape.
It forgives more.
Mm-hmm.
It forgives more, exactly.
And it kind of looks cool.
Yeah. Don't forget to stretch, do some yoga while you're tufting periodically.
I need to.
A bottle of wine helps as well. As does making sure your pants are
still. Oh, yeah. Only way.
Alright, here we go. So this is the last part before we cinch. Okay, pulling. And this is you probably will find this to be the most difficult part. So what you do is you do the cinch. Enough to kind of illustrate where your tuft will be. And then you let it go.
A little bit. So you can
do the tie-off.
So there's a little bit of give, because if not, it's impossible to pass this needle through this
final tie-off stitch. There we go.
See, this is why you need two people.
And you also need two people because you would way give up.
Yeah. Okay, see? Now that
okay,
it's through. One person pulls,
cinches,
keeps it this way without, I'm not pulling yet. Only Hachi is pulling, ready?
Mm-hmm.
And then to keep the tightness so you don't lose the knot.
Okay, knot.
Keep on, oh, sorry. You gotta make a knot, right? Before you close it. If not, it's gonna be loose.
Go. Keep cinching.
Knot goes down.
Amazing. Okay. Finger in.
Knot goes up just on top of the finger. Low as possible.
Okay. Go, go.
And knot. Done.
And there you go.
And cut.